I implemented the changes in todoView.js and in index.html, which is the place where our templates are. Now, I had to figure this one out as well, so here's the thought process I went through. Now first, I knew I had to add the edit button in the same place as the delete button, so I had to figure out where that was. One way to do that would be to pop into our developer tools here and take a look at what that button actually looks like. And if you poke around, you'll find that the button has a class of destroy. So that's what we're looking for. Let's close the developer tools here, and let's go look around for something with a class of destroy. Here it is right here, inside of the same place as before, the item template. Remember, this is the HTML that is going to represent each one of our items. So that's our X button. We want to have an edit button as well. I'm literally going to copy and paste, but I'm going to change the class to that class name that I gave you, edit-btn. If I save this and I go back to the browser and refresh, sure enough, now I should have two buttons, and they look exactly how we want them to look. Now, the only problem is when I click on the edit button, nothing happens. Why not? Well, it's because I haven't wired it up yet. So now that I've tested it and the button shows up, but it doesn't do anything, I need to figure out where is this edit functionality going to live? Well, think about it. The edit functionality already exists. It happens anytime I double click on one of these items. So I need to find where that happens and maybe consider putting the click on my little edit button in that same area. So if I poke around, it turns out I'll find that in the todoView.js. If we go over here and scroll down just a teeny bit, this right here is the events object literal that binds these things to these functions. So how does this actually work? I mean, we'll find edit functionality when we double click on a label. So that seems pretty simple. My guess would be that this is the event, click or double click. This is the CSS selector, dot toggle or label. And this over here, toggle completed or edit or clear, is the actual functionality. If we scroll down, sure enough, there's toggle completed and there is edit. It says in the comment, switch this view into editing mode, displaying the input field. So yes, indeed, this is exactly what we want right here. So we have a double click on label resulting in the edit, and we also want a click event on what? Well, in case the answer isn't popping out at you, let's think about how that destroy button works. In index.html, this button has a class of destroy. When you click on it, something happens, so let's go ahead and take a look and see if we can figure out how that works. When you click on .destroy, run this function. When you click on .edit button, run this function. When you double click on label, run this function. Now I'm kind of intuiting this just by reading the code. When I first did it, I had no idea if it was actually going to work, but because experimentation is cheap and there are no high stakes because of our version control, we can always revert our changes. I'm gonna experiment and try it anyway. I'll save it, go back to my browser, hit refresh, and now if I roll over and I click, sure enough, it runs the edit functionality. I can hit enter to get back, and I can do it with any of these, including these that have not been checked. So that's pretty cool. Now I can also confirm this in the documentation, events and then an object literal. Let's look that up. If we go to backbonejs.org and we scroll down to the area where it talks about views, sure enough, right here at the very top, we have backbone.view.extend, events, and then inside of this, we've got these various things. It turns out this is indeed where we specify our declarative events. We can click on this and read even more about it and understand exactly how it works. Right now, I'm not going to go into this, but just know that the documentation does exist. And if the documentation ever fails you, a Google search will actually do very well as well. Oftentimes, Google searches will link you more effectively to the part of the documentation that you need. So once again, not a very hard process. The specific details of what code I wrote, that doesn't matter. The point is my thought process. Figure out what you need, and then be a detective to figure out where it could best fit in. And lastly, be tofu. Fit your code in as if it was already there originally. make it look exactly the same, you'll notice I did not put a space before my colon. The reason is because the code here does not put a space. I did put a space after. And again, that's because that's what the code here has done. So I'm just going to emulate that.